published 17:30 Eastern Standard Time, the 24th of January 2018, updated 17:30 Eastern Standard Time, the 24th of January 2018. Former FA chairman Lord Triesman on Wednesday promised to write a book about his controversial time at the helm, when lawyers allow. Triesman, who tried to introduce a more moral outlook at the FA before having to resign in 2010 after being caught in a newspaper honey trap, made the pledge about future revelations while helping to promote another account of FIFA shenanigans. He said, "I hope one day to write about it when the lawyers tell me I am no longer going to be sued." Former FA chairman Lord Triesman has pledged to blow whistle on FIFA in his booth. Labour peer was supporting Australian whistleblower Benita Mercedes' Whatever It Takes, the inside story of the FIFA way, her account of the doomed Australian bid to host the 2022 World Cup amid FIFA's murky politics. It is being published by American company Powderhouse Press, who are said to be confident of rebuffing the writs that still worry Triesman. But Triesman said the fundamentals of Mercedes' story, challenging FIFA's procedures, would also be central to his football memoirs, which are already two-thirds written. He said on becoming leader of England's 2018 bid, "I wasn't going to do it the FIFA way. I was livid when I heard our staff had bought handbags to give to people. It wasn't the way to run the bid." A lot of Mercedes' wrath is saved for veteran football strategist Peter Hargitay, who had her sacked from the Australia bid. Hargitay in turn had quit his England 2018 consultancy after Triesman demanded he reapply for his job. But despite Triesman and Mercedes' trenchant opposition, the FA and Football Federation Australia quickly realised that to have any realistic chance of winning a World Cup bid, Hargitay's deep knowledge of the shadowy FIFA way made his expensive services a necessity. He said on becoming leader of England's 2018 bid, "I wasn't going to do it the FIFA way." The British Horse Racing Authority intend to make a double apology to Northern Ireland Secretary Karen Bradley and West Ham Vice Chairman Karen Brady. This follows a clerical error resulting in a letter from BHA Chairman Steve Harmon congratulating former DCMS Secretary Bradley on her promotion being sent to Brady at the House of Lords. Morocco's bid for the 2026 World Cup is not going to help FIFA improve their image. The African country has frequently been named in court and in witness statements as having paid bribes in failed attempts to host the 1998 and 2010 World Cups. The curse of London Stadium continues. Now three communications chiefs connected with a troubled venue: Ben Fletcher of the London Legacy Development Corporation, Michael Temple of Stadium Operators E20 and Max Fitzgerald of Tenants West Ham, have left in quick succession. MCC wanted the fuss over there. Lord's rebuilding plans to die down when an exhaustive survey saw 90% of the membership reject property developer Charles Rifkin's plan to finance new stands to the tune of £150 million in return for building flats at the nursery end. But Rifkin and his supporters remain as active as ever, judging by the appearance on the MCC's online forum this week of a supportive 2011 letter from Sir John Major. Interestingly, the former Prime Minister's letter to the committee was never shared with the backers of the development. MCC wanted the fuss over the Lord's rebuilding plans to die down after 90% of the membership reject plans to finance new stands in return for building flats at the nursery end. Sports suppliers Cookery, who kit out Team England for the Commonwealth Games, don't get much publicity. So it wasn't the best idea for the start of their kitting out for the Gold Coast Games to coincide with the British Olympic Association's similar procedure for next month's Winter Games in Pyeongchang. The Football League's former commercial director Richard Heaselgrave had a reputation for talking a better game than he delivered for the 72 clubs. But that has not been the case since he left in 2014 to join Tennis Australia, whose sponsorship revenues he has increased by £30 million in 4 years. Former Football League chief Richard Heaselgrave has made £30 million for Tennis Australia.